Bramboro back with some aircraft carrier survival in the sandbox mode. In our last episode, we did some base defense somewhere over in this area. I don't remember exactly where. And anyway, since the last time we came out of Pearl Harbor, I've done three, maybe four side missions while we were waiting for our main mission to come available. And it has. It is now the 6th of February, and the main mission is active. When I first took this mission and sailed out of Pearl, this was reflected as a medium to destroy three fleets sometime during the course of saving, exiting, and then rebooting the game. it's becoming easy for two fleets. But we should... I think we're going to get four upgrade points out of this, if I remember correctly. It's been a while. In any case, without further ado, let's get in and sink these fleets.
Sir, a new objective is awaiting.
Okay. And they are both already visible. Okay. Well, we don't want to get detected before we have to. So, for now, I think this is fine for nav. I think half speed should be good. I was going to want to keep my air department up to snuff. I think this one dude in DC with the DC specialty and generalist. And that percentage has come up, so I am like 99% sure that these stack. And I think even generalist on generalist stacks too, because air department is now higher yet again. Got a pretty good air department going here, 169% efficiency. Anyway, I think this crew makeup is fine. Look at our island configuration. Two airstrikes? Yeah, I think that's good. Fighter repair. So we're going to be doing some airstrikes, multiple airstrikes in this mission, and of course, that is the most likely place to take damage to planes, and I have fewer torpedo bombers than anything else. I might have reason to change this later. However, I'm kind of thinking, let's go with torpedo bombers. That seems to make sense. Yeah, I know I'm not moving. It's nighttime. I'm getting to it. I think one DC team is fine. Yeah, having an ID target mission is fine. One is probably enough. That's fine. That's fine. Got enough airstrikes. I typically don't use recon that much. I like to use scouts for that. But... yeah, why don't you come on down here? Let's just go ahead and at least have a recon available. I think that's a good idea. Scouting covers a much larger area. You know, it's 360 degrees, but to go to a specific target, the recon does go farther. So we'll do that. Yeah, carrier defense, definitely. Got enough airstrike missions. Yeah, I want the carrier defense. And yeah, we'll keep DC efficiency prioritized there. Where is my actual guy? Is this me here?
Awaiting orders.
No. No, that is me, isn't it?
Sir!
Where's the Admiral? Doesn't really matter, does it? We'll just kind of mosey off this way. I think that's fine. So the first thing we're going to have to do with this, well, I don't know, I don't really need the recon because they're already reconned. I just need to identify them. So we'll take care of this guy first. So the first thing we're going to need some dive bombers. But I want the dive bombers in front. So first let's bring up some fighters in case needed for Cap. And let's bring up some dive bombers now for the ID. Okay. Okay, we got our crew set, we got our island set, we're bringing up the planes we need for the Dawn launch. Got our targets identified.
Issue a fighter squadron on the deck.
We basically are ready to go for 0500. Just going to leave the and that's real time. That's not a time late posit. So I guess in this mission there's no recon necessary for the fleets. You just always know where they are.
Issue a dive bomber squadron on the deck.
I mean, we kind of gripe about the AI having that ability on us, but hey, I mean, I guess sometimes it works both ways. Oh, I do have to kill them all within 24 hours. If I had known that, I may not... Well, 24 hours is going to be the same amount of night regardless, so it's okay that I came in at that time. I do need to be a little efficient, though, in planning airstrikes. Let's go ahead and prep the ID mission now. And actually, I'm going to wind up going north. I need to get closer to the other fleet. I might have to fly 6 airstrikes, depending on how big these fleets are. There's going to be a time crunch here. And it is possible I may have to deliberately sacrifice some squadrons from time distance. Let them go in the drink.
A section below deck has malfunctioned.
Great.
Send DC teams now.
Start engine.
Let's get the ID message off. All right. So we have 2 fighters on deck now. We know we're going to need... Let's go with 2 torpedo bombers. That's what's needed for the anvil card, which almost always gets used.
Admiral, a section below.
We'll just see how the package is.
Send DC teams now.
for the last two deck slots.
Issue a torpedo bomber squadron on the deck.
Am I still happy? Well, section below it's at least half function. Speed.
Send DC teams now.
This guy's headed south, so I think half speed's okay here.
Issue a torpedo bomber squadron on the deck.
Heavy carrier. This is going to take multiple strikes. I mean, can I get the job done? Yes. Can I get the job done in 18 hours? Especially if the other fleet is even just average? About that. Right, well, we need to prep an airstrike. Okay, minus 10% on attack and defense on offensive maneuvers. All right. Defensive maneuver number 4, minus 30%. Yeah, okay. An attack of all maneuvers using torpedo bombers. The anvil card is usually strong enough that it's still worth doing, even with that. This is going to take 3 strikes. There's 3 shields on this heavy carrier. And oh, by the way, incoming air attacks are probably going to be relatively heavy. All right, let's see what we can do. I like putting anvil attack in slot 5 because then he buffs himself. And Lone Wolf is usually a pretty good card to put in 3. Attack of this maneuver is plus 5 if maneuver 3 is supportive, which is why I put that in there. Okay, we do not want to put it... Let's go ahead and put it... Okay, let's go with slot... Something's going to have to go in slot 4, and I don't want to put a defensive card in a defense-nerfed slot. We're already assured of destroying 1 to 2. But we're still at grave risk. We need to get some defense in here. How about we unlocked this card last time around? How about we put him in 2, leaving us. Can't use Bulwark, that's 2 squadrons. We can use Jinking though. And this will further boost our anvil attack in slot 5. Okay, the attack is pretty decent, but our defense ain't. What happens if I go? I don't know if I really have too much. What if we go with torpedo run here? Still the 4-5, still the 1-2. That doesn't really do us any favors. If this helps at all. I suspect not. Well, a little bit. We went from 4-5 to 3-5, and we still have our 1-2. Alright. 1-3-2 is our configuration now, which... kind of like the idea of targeting the submarine to take away this torpedo bomber debuff. If we target the heavy carrier directly, we're not going to kill it. Or the light carrier. Okay, let's get this debuff out of the way. And I bet we'll get the destroyer as well and take a shield off of each of the carriers. Let's go with this. Got our two torpedo bombers. We actually need two. Put a fighter squadron back down. We need to start bringing up dive bombers.
Issue a dive bomber squadron on the deck. Issue a dive bomber squadron on the deck. Issue a dive bomber squadron on the deck. Stand by to start engine.
Also need, as soon as the launch is done, we need to recover those identify mission guys.
Admiral, we're taking water. You should send DC teams to pump it out.
Stand by to recover aircraft.
Ow. Ow. That is not a good result. We've lost three squadrons, and we did get the submarine that we were targeting, but we didn't get even the destroyer, and we didn't take any shields off of the carriers. Okay, well, gotta get another strike going. Look at that defense. Oh my goodness. At least our torpedo bombers ought to be even more effective now. What to target? This destroyer isn't actually providing any modifier debuffs. Do we go for the sure thing, or do we try to... Let's try to get this light carrier. Okay. Let me go with a similar package. Except maybe this time, let's try the bulwark. Ooh, that is not good enough. I feel like I want to get jinking in there because of the way that it buffs, but what if I go... If I'm going to get a card nerf, let's get the lower defense. Yeah. This card is doing diddly in that slot. Get that out of there. How about this? Five to six, coming back heavily damaged. I think I may have to. We need more defense than what Lone Wolf gives us. I faint. About striking the sun. Well, that's giving us a pretty good attack, and it will destroy this light carrier, but we're still at 5-6. I can't imagine that going defensive bombing instead of janking is going to do us much good. Lowered this a little bit, but it will not kill the light carrier. If anyone's wondering, no, time doesn't run while you're doing this. Okay, gotta do it, and just let's hope that most of these come back needing repair, not actually downed. It's another 132 package. And we currently have one of the dive bombers. Okay.
Spot the deck. Prepare for launching.
So we need to bring up 122.
Issue a fighter squadron on the deck.
Easy mission, they said.
Issue a dive bomber squadron on the deck. Issue a torpedo bomber squadron on the deck. Issue a torpedo bomber squadron on the deck.
Okay, we should have, yep, we can now cue the launch that the last squadron is considered on deck, even though they're still moving. So that's queued up. And we're going to have to switch to recovery as soon as this is done, because we got to recover the other strike. Almost all of whom are probably going to need to go into the hangar. There's not that many squadrons there. Well, there's three squadrons, because we lost three. There were six in the strike. I think two of those are going to need repair. No, only one.
Stand by to recover aircraft.
It's kind of hard to see through that. Okay, should be any second. Ooh, and that other fleet is getting close. Not sure how much that matters, really. At least we're temporarily undetected. Kind of surprised they haven't popped an attack on us yet. They probably have, we just haven't caught it on radar yet. Okay, we've got AA manned. However, while I've still got time... Well, that's a better result. We did get the light carrier, and we did get the submarine. We lost three more squadrons, and torpedo bombers are going to all need repair. I did probably... Man, we are burning some aircraft here. Let's do this. Okay, that'll work. What do we have to work with here? Got a ton of fighters in the hangar bay, but we've got two. Torpedo and two dive bombers available. And we've also got the one dive. So, yeah, I mean, we could go with a similar package, which ought to be getting more viable. But we have to recover this airstrike in order to... You know what? There is an order for...
Full focus now.
Did I just mess something up? I thought I was buying myself another airstrike mission. We did. Okay. There's just a counter on it because of the order. Still no shields off of that heavy carrier, man. At least slot 4 has got better defense now. It's still way above 100 for defense. Attack of all following maneuvers. 25. This is... Definitely damage one enemy target will not destroy it. So we still need more attack. Defense plus 4 if the previous maneuver used fighters. We don't have that. Attack plus 5 if maneuver number 3 is supportive. ...93 attack. And we're still not getting a definite kill. We're just going to have to wear it down. Maybe it'll still get the... What happens if we do this? But I feel like if I go this route, okay, they lose the destroyer. But I may not even take a shield off the carrier. Which I gotta do. So, we're down to 1-2, we'll return. Okay, that's a 1-2-3 configuration. We have We have got to recover this strike first, though. Or do we? No, I don't think we do.
Clear the flight deck.
Spot for launch. Oh, crap. I can't do this one. This requires 3 torpedo bombers. Double check that. I got 3 torpedo bombers. I have 1 torpedo bomber and 1 dive bomber, so I need 2 torp, 1 dive, 1 fighter.
Issue a torpedo bomber squadron on the deck.
Nope, we got an attack coming in. And we have a 3.5 hour cooldown on this order, so I can't go defensive position. That sucks. Let's go ahead and put... No, I'm going to save Saipan's cap.
Issue a torpedo bomber squadron on the deck.
And hope... There's one thing I've still got plenty of fighters. Maybe I can get a cap mission off before that attack gets here. Oh, by the way, I also need to identify that other stupid fleet, which it's 4 ships. I was hoping it might be a little smaller.
Issue a dive bomber squadron on the deck. Issue a fighter squadron on the deck.
Okay. Go.
Launch aircraft.
There's also a scout. That scout mission they got, the counter scout mission, is pretty low priority right now, I think. Do I have to wait for the entire launch to go before some of these slots open up? I guess so. Oh, and we got some kamikazes coming in. Okay, let's go ahead and put up Saipan's cap for this first attack, and then we'll get our cap up for the kamikaze attack. Seems to be in Chicopee. How about some torpedo bombers?
Sir, a member of your staff requires urgent medical aid. Have a DC team transport
on your
to the infirmary.
Yeah, I gotta wait for that entire launch to be done before any of the slots open up and I can queue up some fighters to come up. I think we'll make it, though.
Squadron on the deck.
I want to wait until this first attack actually commences before launching. Otherwise, I'll wind up burning two cap, ours and Saipan's, on the one attack.
Issue a fighter squadron on the deck.
Nine hours left. Okay. We're waiting for the attack. How we doing on dive? Okay. We took two shields off of the heavy carrier. That's a good thing. And we did lose another squadron, but much better a fighter than torpedo or even dive bombers. Okay. Well, let's see what we have to work with. Five fighters, one dive, two torpedo. Those are the two we got from Chicopee. What is the highest attack fighter? Not very much. This one gives a nice... I like this card. That's pretty good. That's a pretty good package for one squadron of fighters. We don't really need this card in this slot, though. We need to go for complete destruction here, and we need to just keep adding attack until we get it. Which means, and I can't use a torpedo bomber card. Two's all we got. Here we go with this guy again. One to two will be destroyed. Okay. And I think we can afford to use another dive bomber. Okay. So this works. We just need to get Lone Wolf into slot 3. Total destruction, opposing forces, 1 to 3, heavily damaged. Okay, and that is a 1-3-2 configuration. Of which we currently have... actually need to get a... But what I need to do is launch this darn cab. So we got a clean deck. And I actually need to recover. I need to recover dive bombers before I can launch that strike. Are there dive bombers here? There's one. There's not enough. Okay, we're not going to have AA for the next attack. I don't think we're going to make it 3.5 hours before these guys show up. We are going to have cat momentarily. That'll get us up to 4. And I think we might squeeze in defensive position here in time. And by the time these guys get recovered, these guys should be back and available. I don't know. I don't know about this. Yeah, I have to recover this strike in order to have the dive bombers. I need to recover both of those strikes before I have the dive bombers. Come on! Get there! 2 minutes. Two minutes.
On the double! Same old, full focus now.
To recover aircraft.
Basically, I kind of have to hope that after recovery of both airstrikes that we're at or very close to the 132 configuration, otherwise this airstrike is going to expire its feasibility. Double check our It seems an odd recovery area. I guess I better speed up and get into it. This would be a good time for that plane fuel management if I wasn't in defense.
Staff requires urgent medical aid.
Okay. DC team. We got a guy on medical. And what's my other one here?
A member of your staff requires urgent medical aid.
Is it
Have
2?
A DC team transport him to the infirmary.
I know one's a medical. What's the other one? I don't see it. And I'm not moving my medical. That guy's just hanging out. Maybe it was two medicals.
Ready.
Well, the only one left is medical, and they're both on medical, so... The strike group is outside the mission's recovery area! Bah! We're almost in it. I guess I drew that thing out too far. Less than 7 hours. Newsflash, I don't think this is happening. Hey, we have burned a lot of squadrons for zip. Okay, well. Don't want to move that guy. Don't want to move that guy. Okay. And I'm working on squadrons repair. I don't want to move. Stay pat with that crew configuration. There we go. Get on deck. This kind of goes back to something I was talking about, I think, in the last episode. About, just kill two fleets. I can do that. Oh, we didn't mention the time crunch in the mission brief. You have to step away from the computer for several minutes. I'll cut this bit out. Alrighty then. Okay, this cap can just basically stay in the Marshall stack for the remainder of the mission. I don't need to worry about recovering him at all. We've got more fighters than we have. Anything else? It says 9 there for torpedo bombers, but notice that there's 3 on mission. I think that includes torpedo bombers that have been shot down. Or maybe it's these 3 guys. How in the world do I have 9 torpedo bombers? I didn't... Started with 6. Got several shot down. I didn't get that many from Chicopee. Okay, we have torpedo bombers on deck. I'm gonna need fighters and dive bombers. That I just don't think we have. Well, I'll tell you what. We are getting... Well, there's only 2.5 hours left until sunset, so we have even less time remaining than this shows. We haven't even put a dent or identified in fleet number 2. And the sad truth is, you know, we have sunk ships, but you don't get anything for that. I mean, this mission is going to be a 0 regardless. If I manage to get another airstrike off before sunset, okay, I might sink some enemy ships, but that is fruitless. And now I'm delayed even more because I got the wrecked plane over there. Basically, the only thing that can happen is I lose more squadrons. That is the only yeah, there's no upside to flying another airstrike. Only downside. And given that, I think as soon as this order expires, I'm going to beat feet. Just cancel that. No reason not to recover those.
Stand by to recover aircraft.
I see where I messed up. I thought I had lost a bunch of torpedo dive bombers is where we got our butt kicked. I should have gotten dive bombers from Chicopee, not torpedoes. All right. I'm out.
Better get to it. On the double.
We'll be back, IJN. Guess it should at least respot the deck in case we have an attack coming in during the next 2 hours. Okay, so in terms of management of the actions, I'm sure I could have been a little bit more efficient.
Respot the deck.
But I don't think that was terribly bad. I definitely don't think that there was enough slop in there that if I had tightened up would have been enough to complete the mission. So to the extent that my technique could have been better, and I'm sure it could have, absolutely, it wasn't the main story. I think it just boils down to the cards I have available and the planes I have available. I have not upgraded these planes. These are all, you know, Buffaloes, Vindicators, and Devastators. No Avengers, no Dauntlesses. So, aircraft quality is probably a factor. And I have spent most, not all, but most of my post-mission medals on buffing the enlisted crew. I have done not very much with officers. And so I don't have an awesome set of cards either. I mean, they're good enough for most things. Like, if this mission had not had the timer on it, yeah, I would have gotten those fleets somehow, eventually. It would have taken me 2 days. But I don't yet have the oomph in the air wing and the strike package cards to be able to one-shot a fleet or, two shot a fleet like the one we just had with the heavy carrier in it that has three shields. Okay, well, I mean, I'm still going to stay with the strategy, kind of, I mean, the development strategy that I've been working on, which is to try to get the carrier upgraded to Yorktown. But, yeah, I need to get the... at one point soon, I need to get some better planes. And I probably ought to start spending the majority of my medals on officers rather than crew. Medals like I'm not going to get here. In any case, I'd rather, and we definitely need to go back to Pearl Harbor. Because I got snow planes. Or I got holes in the air wing. All right then. I think that will do for this episode. As unsuccessful as it may have been. But thank you very, very much for watching. I appreciate it.